Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 33. Today I'm post-processing outside the box and using Nick Color Efex Pro to create two stylized versions of an otherwise photo. The photo is one of the many sentry boxes that line the fortified wall of Old San Juan, Puerto Rico. And as you can see, the original image is underexposed. So the first thing I'm going to do is come up to my exposure slider and increase the exposure to, I'm going to bring it to about 1.75. And from here, I'm going to take it into Color Efex Pro. And I do that by clicking on the image, right-clicking on the image. It brings up my menus and voila, there we go. Now, as Color Efex starts to think, I want to edit a copy with Lightroom adjustments already made, and it's going to create a TIFF file and place it in my film strip. And it is to that file that the changes that I make in Color Efex Pro will be brought back. So here we go, it's loading the image. And for some reason, this must be my favorite filter, the detail extractor, because it always loads it first and I can't seem to clear it out. But in this case, this is the one that I want to use. However, I want to show you how I get there. So I'm going to X out and I'm going to show you how to get there. So you click over here on the left and it pulls up the menu of all the tons of filters in the program, and I have starred my favorites, and here's the detail extractor, and I'm going to click on this icon and it's going to bring up four different presets. Now I'm going to bring up the default preset just to show you what the sliders are, what the panel looks like, and you can certainly, in the default, it allows you to play with the sliders on your own. The detail extractor, overall, it balances the light and tonality and extracts detail throughout the image. The main slider here will lighten shadows and darken highlights while adding detail. I'll show you. I'm just playing with these sliders. You can see the chains as you move. The contrast and the saturation, of course, are pretty self-explanatory, increase and decrease. The effect radius button is interesting. It controls how the filter brings out the detail. Fine focus on this will bring out focuses on small objects that create more texture. And large will go up through the normal. Let's see, is that changing? Let's go up through the large. It's subtle. But the large works only on large objects. So with that little bit of background in place, what I want to do, because there are three presets that Nick Efex, Color Efex provides, and I typically start with the presets, and you can always tweak the sliders within the presets. But so here's detail extractor, the strong large number 2, but what I want to do is change it to fine, because I want more of a fine art effect. So let's see, there's the fine, so you can perhaps see the difference. There's the normal, and there's the large. So back to fine. I just love how it really pulls out the details in these grasses on the wall, and more in the clouds. So I'm satisfied with my choice of this filter, and I'm going to add a second. So I come down here and I click Add Filter, and I go back to the main menu. And I go back to the main menu, and it's frozen. Oh, back, because I'm clicking on the wrong button. See, the things you learn here are what to do and what not to do. The next filter I applied is called Tonal Contrast, and I'll click there. And the one that I used, and tonal contrast controls textures, also controls textures and details throughout your image. Here's the default, and you can see all the different sliders that there are. Contrast type, again, you have a lot of different choices here, and you choose to select how the filter will affect the details in your photo, and this one as well. Here I chose the preset high pass, but I wanted to tone down the contrast in the midtones because I wanted to give it a little bit more of a realistic feel, and it's such as can be the case in this. And here you can click and toggle the effect of the selection by clicking on and off. Or if I remove the detail extractor, you can see what the tonal contrast filter did, which really wasn't a whole lot for the original picture. So you can isolate the effects of each one, which is nice. Okay, now the next filter is one that I always use, and again, click on the back to get to the menu. It is darken, lighten, center. This is basically a radial filter, like in Lightroom, and used to apply a post-crop vignette. Again, you can manually select and adjust the sliders, or you can start with presets. I tend to always start with maximum depth and then tweak the sliders from there. And you'll see I'm going to click it off and click it on. So this, here's where we're starting. And you begin here with the shape. The shape number one is round and shape number two is vertical. And given the subject of this and the fact that it's in a portrait mode, I choose number two. Center luminosity, well, I'm going to slide it. You'll see it just, of course, does what it suggests. It decreases or increases the brightness of the center point. And here, because the center is too bright and blowing out a little bit of details, I'm going to bring it down to about here. Now, the border luminosity is what the edges, darkens and lightens the edges. I decided to leave at 100%. And then, of course, the center size, the default is 55%, but you can make it bigger and smaller. I chose to leave it at the default position. Now, here's something that's real important about this filter is the place center. This will place the filter wherever you want to place it. So I'll show you what I mean by clicking in random places. I'm going to place it there. You see how it moves the filter to where I've placed the crosshatch. But here, I'm going to come back and there. So I've placed it where I like it. And this is the last thing that I've done with this photo. It's kind of a fine art effect, and I'm going to click off all of these sliders so you can see what the original was. And there's the first iteration of this photo. Now, something that's important here, if you want to come back and work on this photo again, instead of starting from scratch because you know you've done adjustments to sliders, you can save the recipe. You click Save Recipe and it pulls up the box, you type in the name and you hit OK. And I will show you where it takes you. I'm going to click out of here. It takes you to the recipes folder where you can see I've stored a lot of different recipes so that I can come back to a specific any photo that I want and apply any of these specific recipes that I've saved. But for now, because I've already saved it, I am going to come back into this recipe and I'm going to add another filter because I want to see what this looks like and play with it in black and white. So I'm going to come back to the main menu once again, and they have a black and white conversion. They have a bunch of filters here. And for this one, I played around. Let's pull it up. All different effects. I chose dynamic filter here, number 5. Now, it was a bit too low key for me, and so I started removing some of the previous filters, and I ended up removing the tonal contrast. And when I did that, for me, this just reminds me of like an old horror movie, black and white from the 1930s, Bela Lugosi, Dracula, whatever. And I love it. And so that is my second stylized version of the photo. Again, I can save the recipe and rename it something with the black and white appendix or appendage, whichever. No, that would be a leg or a foot. Anyway, you get the idea, extension. one other point, here's the history box, so you can go back in time to a step if you get lost in what you're doing. That's a helpful thing to know. It actually, I didn't find this for quite some time when I first started using the program, so it was frustrating for me. Okay, I'm going to save this, the black and white photo, just so that you can see the workflow. I click on save. It's saving image. And it's going to bring this image back into my film strip, into that TIFF file that was originally created. Give it a second. Slowly but surely. Okay, there's the empty TIFF. There we go. Okay, so again, I'm going to show you the original. You know, nice, but there wasn't much you could really do with it in my estimation. Here's the first iteration, and then there's the second. Okay, so a little bit of fun. It's I have a good time just playing around with things and seeing what I can come up with. Anyway, I hope that you have enjoyed the video. For those of you watching on YouTube, you can see more after, before galleries of photos and more videos on visualventuring.com. Look for After Before Friday in the menu, and thanks for watching.